What's up, everybody? Today I wanted to do a quick little tutorial on the 10 things that you're gonna need for doing a house reno or demolition on a full house, partial house, part house, maybe a couple extras. And foremost, sledgehammers. We're talking big and small ones, handheld one, really good for a lot of different things. Large one with a good amount of weight, awesome. Now you can get ones with the points on, but make sure you have a flat head. Good workout tool, also will crush everything. Good for knocking out studs, tile, cabinets, everything. Really good to have. One of my favorite tools out there, crowbars, small, big. This is important. Get the one with the nail hole remover so you can pop those nails. Once you pull out the drywall, once you pull out the lath and plaster, whatever you got, this will get the job done on small stuff or around trim and windows. This guy will get this stuff done on big stuff. Also, make sure it's the flat kind, not the big hook. You can actually get up under stuff with this one. You want this end on the other side, which is flat, really sharp, gets up underneath stuff. So, number three might be one of my favorite tools I've ever owned, so take that to heart here, is the Sawzall. Now, this is a Makita. These are amazing. They cut through everything. You gotta be careful with them, but the cool part with these is you can actually twist it, switch out blades. This is an all-purpose blade. But say you're cutting through a stud and there's a nail, it's good to have this so you can just right through, open up that wall. I use this for so much stuff in demo. I've used it multiple times on multiple houses and it's the jam. And make sure you have tons of blades on hand because you're gonna need them because you go through them. Number four. Trash can and a bucket. These are so good for getting rid of all the crap. This one is great for one person or two. You can fill it all the way up. It's got this little handle at the bottom so I can throw it up and over the dumpster. This guy is when your friends are gone and you just need a little bit of help, but you don't have much strength left. The bucket is great for that. Also, if your house leaks, you can have these around and they're really good if for some reason your flashing is bad or something's going on. Number five, shovel. I think this is a really important thing to have on hand, and I like the flathead with the big scooper. Now this is starting our protection. I'm not a safety expert, so don't take my word for it. Check other sources for safety. But here are the things that I use for safety in this checklist. I would get a mask. Make sure you get ones that are good for dust, mold, everything like that. Throw it up and over, just like that. Really important to always be wearing these when you're doing demo. I think a lot of people forget, but your lungs, you gotta protect those things. Gloves. Now, I buy my gloves in 3-packs from Home Depot, because they're like 10 bucks, and with demo, you're gonna go through gloves like crazy, because you're picking up sharp objects with tile and metal mesh and all this stuff, and they kinda rip, and you don't wanna waste your expensive leather gloves on that. And so I made that mistake on the first house, not on this one. Right, number seven, and I take this one very seriously, is eye protection, right here. I think this one is one of the most important, yet sometimes forgot. But I wear sunglasses because I am outside, and inside I'm just going in and out. Some people wear the clear glasses. Just make sure they're tight to your face. There's actually safety approved ones. Number eight is a hammer. This guy right here, it's an underrated tool, but I just keep this on me at all times because if I need to pop a nail, hit something quick. Okay, so number nine is to check circuits to make sure you're not gonna tear out an outlet or a switch or a wire that's hot. There's this one that you can stick in the outlets. It's amazing. I don't have it on me, but that's number nine on this list. Before you start demo, there's a couple things you wanna do. One, check all the breakers, mark and label beside them where they go, and then crank them all off, okay? Because you're gonna be cutting these suckers out. You do not wanna be electrocuted, so important. Turn off the gas probably, because you don't wanna accidentally hit a gas line, house fill up with gas, okay? So very important. All right. Here it is, coming in strong right at you, is friends. Bring your friends. Hello, we love you, hope this was helpful. We'll see you on Wednesday. This was just a short little segment to show you what we're doing. Bye.